What up, what up? We're back again. UFC 148. I can't tell you how excited I am for this. Bringing you the same people who've been breaking down UFC. We've done this at least three times now. We're ready for UFC 148. I'm UTX JG the Don. Nando, say what up, man.
Well, it's good, PTG Part-Time Gamers. It's not that serious. Y'all know what it is.
Ziggy, what's good? Tell them what it is.
Yo, 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 Ziggy, and that's all I have. I don't have no good introduction like that.
I don't even want JG doing the intro no more. His intro is like a lot better than mine. Like, fuck you, JG. Trying to outshine and shit. First he gets the views, and now he wants to be like the shit in the motherfucking commentary. You know, it's all right.
I like you though, man.
We gonna have to kick him out, dude. We need another guy.
Let's go ahead. You know we do the top three fights, especially if the card is kind of whack. We all know what we're here for. We want to see Silva and Sonnen, but let's go ahead and start off with Leon Cote. Nando, go ahead and tell us what you think about this fight.
Fuck, man. Lee got his ass kicked last time by Wanderlei. And before that, he was doing all these movies and shit.
Yep, he's Hollywood.
Hollywood. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, and Cote hasn't been around. And I don't know, I mean, I don't know if his last fight was Silva, but his last fight that I saw was Silva, was him versus Silva. He got wrecked. He fucked up his knee, or leg or some shit, like Siggy said. So this fight, even though it's a top three fight, I still don't give a fuck about it. You know what I mean?
Damn.
It's like, yeah, straight up.
Boy, that was 3 years ago with the Silva fight.
Yeah, he's look at that, bro.
That was UFC 90.
It went from double digits to three digits.
Yeah, that's ancient, man. That's a lot of UFC events. Damn.
But the one thing I do remember from the fight was that he wasn't exciting. So, you know what I mean? If you're not excited and you're not entertaining me, then I don't really care. I mean, I'm obviously going to watch the event and all that shit. But this fight, I'll give it to Lee because maybe... Wanderlei got him because he's just a stronger dude. I think Cote is gonna still try to be slow and boring, and I think Leo get him on that aspect, do some crazy shit, and maybe catch him. You know, so those are my two cents. But in reality,
Yeah, I agree. Actually, I mean, I was going for Lee so bad. We did the breakdown with him last time. It wasn't that long ago. It was only like 4 or 5 UFC ago with Lee, and he got smoked so bad, I figured he'll never be able to fight again. But
yeah, for real. I thought he was going to go back to movies and right? Shit.
Man, he tweeted that picture of him afterwards, too. Holy damn. I don't even know how he has eyesight. But
I didn't catch that one.
No, I didn't see it either, but man. I figured it just looked like my asshole after fight passage and shit. I'm just saying.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. But, I mean, you would think that this... I mean, he used to be a real good fighter, and you think that that would be motivation enough. Obviously, if he didn't feel like he had something left, he wouldn't have gone all the way. He's already Hollywood, so it's not like he really needs UFC anymore. Well, yeah, I agree. I think I'll pick Lee because, yeah, I think, what's his face? Cote, I don't even know how to say his name.
Patrick Cote.
Yeah, Patrick Cote.
He lost the last, like, three fights in UFC, and he's been winning now somewhere else now. I think he's not even in UFC anymore. Now he's back, but I don't even think he was fighting UFC for a while. So... yeah, I'll go with Lee. What do you think, JG?
It's unanimous, man. I'm going with Lee on this one. I honestly don't even know who Patrick Cote is. And if you all said that the last time that you all seen a fight was against Silva, and it's been so long ago, this fight is irrelevant in my eyes, too. So I don't really care. But, yeah, if I have to go with anyone, I'm going with Lee. That's pretty much it on that one. Oh,
I'm going to tell you like this. His last three fights he lost. And the third one was Anderson Silva. Then it was Alan Belcher. And then it was Tom Lawler. Alan Belcher's a beast, so I can't even take it away. I can't even blame Cote for that. And Tom Lawler got some hands. I mean, he's not like a great fighter, but he got some, he got power in his hands. And like I said, he did lose his last three fights, so I think this is his last chance. He loses this, he's gone. He's ghost peace later. I'll see you in fucking, I don't know, what's the other one? Strike Force or some shit?
Yeah. Well, all right. It is what it is on that fight. Second fight, Griffin and Ortiz.
Part three, right? Is that what this
one
is?
Yeah, this is part three.
Yeah, okay. So, Ortiz, apparently this is his last fight. Yep. So
it might be Griffin's too, to be honest.
It's pretty much, yeah, they're old. And I don't think that Griffin will be fighting anymore either. So, just like you said, this is pretty much a win you know, if you win, that's it. You left on a good note, you lose, and no one will remember you, or they'll remember you for getting your ass whooped. So, Ortiz has been trying to come back, and when he did come back, did he win his last fight? I'm pretty sure he did.
He lost. The last one Ortiz did lost, because I remember he recovered, right?
Yeah, he won the one before, though.
You talking about against him, Griffin against Ortiz?
No, not against Griffin. His Ortiz's last fight, period.
Yeah, Ortiz fought Nogueira last and lost.
And lost, yeah.
Oh, he lost that one, yeah, but he won the one previous, so that's, it's...
No, then the one before that, he lost to Rashad.
Yeah, he lost to Rashad.
And then before that, he won to Ryan Bader.
Damn, so he really did, okay. So yeah, he did two fights. Damn, so, okay, Ortiz came back and literally had three fights before this one.
Yeah,
I guess some of the new fights he has.
The last big fight that he won was Ken Shamrock, dude. That's telling you something right there. In 2006.
Yep.
Tito Ortiz is done, bro. He's done.
Griffin did beat him last time they fought. You know, that's a. I mean, they were both old, so you would figure that if you just go by the history.
But he beat him by split decision. I think ever since Griffin got knocked the fuck out by Anderson Silva, that shit fucked him up.
It did.
You know what I mean? It totally fucked up his mental.
Gave him nightmares and shit.
Yeah, seriously, dude. Like, he, like, literally, like, ran out the fucking cage and dipped. No interviews, nothing. He was, like, scared and shit. So, I think he needs to step it up. I think Tito has absolutely nothing to lose. It's his last fight on his contract. And Griffin's, like, at a fork in the road of his life. And he's like, all right, what am I going to do? You know, because if anything, he can be like that gatekeeper at 2005. I mean, 2005 at 205.
Yeah.
But he's nothing. He's not. He's never going to be a contender. Not with the young guys that we got now.
Right. He's definitely not going to be championship contender again like he once was. So, I really don't know how to gauge this one. But who I would want to win, I guess I would want Ortiz to win just because this is the last fight. Yeah, I kind of want Ortiz just to get
douche
this one.
Loving. You are douche loving homo.
What? Wow. No, okay, I'm sorry. Never root for Ortiz either, but I want him to win this one, man. Just give it to the old guy.
Nah, I like after that lost. Even though the loss to Silva happened in 2009, I still say after the loss to Silva, he deserves to win every fucking match he fights. You know, because that loss was crazy. And then again, he did lose to Rua last fight. His last fight was against Rua, and he lost that fight. He got fucked up by Rua. That was right before Rua got fucked up by Jones.
Yeah.
You know, so. I would go for Griffin. I don't know who's going to win because they're both a little eh. You know what I mean? I mean, obviously, recently Forrest has done better because he beat Rich Franklin and he beat Tito Ortiz back in 2009. Rich Franklin in 2011. But, you know, there you go. Look at the gaps in fighting, dude. He hasn't been fighting a lot. I think it's about that time. So I think this is like a retirement fight. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, both of them. It's gonna be like at the end, the fight's gonna be both of them knocking each other out.
It's
saying?
It's gonna be like the Rocky and Apollo ending where they both knock each other.
Knockouts and shit. Yeah,
I actually, you know what? I'm gonna be with JG. I want to see Ortiz, you know, win the last fight that he fights because I think Griffin might stick around for one more fight. Obviously, he's already tweeted out that he's done after this Tito. So I want to see him go on top. As far as not necessarily on top, but. Winning at least, you know, avenging the loss that he recently had at Griffin. So I think Tito could win though too because he has been fighting a little bit more though. I think maybe that's going to be the difference in the end. Griffin's been taking time, like every couple of years he decides he wants to fight. So, and then also let's not forget that Rashad Evans fight, that was he lasted pretty good. I think it was deep in the second round and he just came off of fighting, you know, Vader what, like a month before that. It was, I don't even know why he was in that fight.
Yeah, it was literally the next one. Yeah, 132 to 133. He literally fought in the very next UFC event.
You're right, you're right.
So I don't know why. He probably thought he was a young Tito Ortiz where he can do that. I mean, that's stupid.
That is really stupid. He fought July 2nd, won to Ryan Bader, and then fought August 6th to a little, maybe just about a month. Yeah, that was stupid.
Yeah, that makes no sense for somebody, especially past his prime, to try to fight. I mean, Evans is a pretty older dude, too, but Evans is no, you know, he's no Griffin.
No. I again, me, in my opinion, I don't like Tito Ortiz. I'm a big Griffin fan. I think Tito has done enough winning by marrying a fucking porn star, so...
That's true, too.
Fuck Tito Ortiz, I'm Griffin all the way, so...
Alright, so you're Griffin, point. I'm Tito, and JG,
and
you're Tito.
And I'm Tito. Alright, so two for Tito, and Nando's over there for Griffin, because he hates Ortiz. Alright, and the main event, there we boy, go. Have talk. I been excited for this, because yes, I fucking hates on his guts.
Do and you? It's
been, yes.
Yeah, I hate him too. I don't like him. I don't like him either. He's a punk. But
it was so much controversy for this fight. And after everything that happened, after Silva came out with that win in round five, first time they fought, I truly believe that Silva was injured because it just didn't seem like him. And every fight after that, he had a spectacular knockout. So I truly believe that Silva wasn't 100% then, and then all this controversy with Sonnen and his medical condition and them saying that his testosterone was too high and then getting suspended, having all of this other controversy with him and his constant shit talking. He's saying that he's the best and not really admitting that he got beat, that he tapped to Silva.
Yeah, he still thinks he didn't tap. Yeah, what kind of shit is that?
I looked at the fight again too. He clearly tapped. And yeah, they replayed it. Yeah, now the even more big thing about this fight, Silva is talking shit back.
Yeah.
And everyone is just like, wow. So this is pretty much the person who, if anybody, this is the person who Silva literally wants to beat the shit out of. And just to hear what he said to Sonnen, I truly believe that Silva is going to make this man bloody. He's going to knock his ass out. And he's going to just have no remorse. So, of course I have Silva.
I tell you this much. I hope to God that if Silva wins, he beats the shit out of him. That's what I want to see. What I don't want to see is Silva running away and dancing like a little bitch.
No, nah, he won't do that. There's no
That's
way
what I'm saying.
Dude, I don't think he will. This fight,
say,
for sure.
Say what you say, but Silva got his ass kicked last fight, these two fought.
That's true.
All right?
But that
he got his ass kicked. They fought like, what, 3 years ago? 2 years ago?
Two years ago. Yeah, they fought in 2010.
You know what I'm saying? And Sonnen put it to him, dude. Why? Because Sonnen wasn't fucking scared. You know what I'm saying? He just went at him. That's what people need to do. And that's what you're gonna see, that eventually somebody's gonna do to Jones and somebody's gonna do to GSP. You know what I'm saying? Because you see all these motherfuckers that be on top, it's because they get this aura around them and people get scared and they just don't know how to fight them right. Or they'll start and then they see that they get hit once and boom, that's they fold. You know what I'm saying? And that's what didn't happen to Sonnen, you know? So I'm thinking, not only is Sonnen the only one to get five rounds with this dude and look like he was beating the shit out of him, but he's also the only dude to get under Silva's skin. You know what I'm saying?
No,
yeah, so, I in all honesty, in my opinion, in one direction, I'm like, damn, I don't really like Sonnen. He's a punk. I'm like, I don't really like the dude, you know? But at the other hand, Silva has been on top for way too long, and he has gotten way too cocky. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He needs, if he's gonna stay on top, he needs to be like Bones and demolish people.
Yeah. The Sonnen fight, though. Yeah. He was man, real close to losing that fight, wasn't he? In fact, I think the judges have four rounds for Sonnen.
Yeah, that's it. If it would have gone to the decision, he would have lost.
Yeah, he would have lost handily too. It would have been 4-1 or something. Yeah.
Yeah. If not five.
Yeah.
If not all five.
It probably would have been all five rounds. Yeah. He had it down the board.
You know. All I'm saying is, now again, I'm not a fan. I'm a big fan of Silva because the dude's crazy beast. But all that dancing around it's a turnoff. It's a turnoff. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to see the main event, some dude fucking dancing around. Like that fight against Maya, it was over. That's it.
It was funny, though. It was funny, but I totally understand. People pay big money to get to these fights. UFC is not cheap by any means.
No way.
And you don't want your top fighter dancing around and playing with the ref and saying, hit me, and Maya not doing anything. I agree that Maya was scared, and it was funny at the time, but I understand why Dana White threatened Silva and said, I'm going to take your belt if you keep doing this. And then after that, Silva changed his ways, and he's actually been getting good fights. fights, even though he's been pretty much dominant, besides Sonnen. Sonnen was literally the only person who took him there.
Why was Mai even in that fight, though? I think maybe Silva was proving a point, too. It's like, why are you having this guy fight me? Give me somebody else.
Well, that is true. That is true. I remember hearing something like that. But, I mean, it is what it is. You fight who you get. You know what I mean? And then you... Dude, if you really wanted to prove a point, you go in there, dude, and you finish him. Yeah, and destroy him
first round, no problem.
You know what I'm saying? If you want to play with him the way Bones did with fucking Stephen Bonner, throw him around. You know what I'm saying? Those crazy elbows. Remember that fight with Bonners and Bones?
Yep.
That's how you fucking prove a point and you play with somebody, dude. You fucking do all them crazy tricks. You want to fuck around, dude? Run on the fence and kick him. Like what's his face did to Benson? Pettit. Anthony Pettit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, if you want to prove a fucking point, dude, there's a better way to do it than fucking dancing around. You know what I'm saying? So, like, after that, like I said, it was just a total turnoff. So, I've just been waiting for somebody to beat the shit out of Silva.
Now, I think, though, you know, I'm going to put my 2 cents on this thing. I think the fight's going to be pretty damn close just because I think Sonnen can take anything Silva throws at him. I think, though, Silva, you know, you would think, at least I would, like you said, I would hope this will happen, that he wouldn't want to dance around, that he wants to take this seriously, that he realizes that if it wasn't for that, you know, choke or whatever he did on him, that he wouldn't
triangle,
that he wouldn't have been able to win that fight. So you would think that, okay, if he maybe he was hurt, who knows? Because, yeah, he didn't look at himself either. You're right about that. But he has to come out and try to get this fight done first two rounds, because I think Sonnen has proved that he can go the distance with him no matter what. I think Sonnen has learned a lot since. I actually think he's actually a pretty damn good fighter. But I think Silva, if he comes out, you know, dedicated, wanting to beat some ass, I think he can beat Sonnen. And I think it's going to be pretty close, but I think maybe probably the end of the second round, Silva wins knockout. That's what I'm thinking. That's what I'm hoping for anyways.
Yeah, I think this is at least going to, because I don't think Silva, even though he wants to, I don't think he's going to finish on it. He might get close, depending on how serious he is, but I think it's at least going two rounds as well, and I think it's going to be a TKO. I think it's going to be a ref stoppage.
From who? From Silva to Sonnen?
Yeah.
I know. Ref stoppage. I think either Silva is going to straight up TKO him, like somehow knock him the fuck out. Like, not no ref stop. Like, I'm talking about, like, he's going to be out cold. Or he's going to submit him real quick. Or they're going to go the distance and Sonnen's going to get decision.
That's what I was going to say. If it goes the distance, Sonnen wins, then you would think, right? Because that means Silva didn't do enough to try to get him out.
Exactly. Right. I mean, Sonnen probably took him down and probably did the same ground and pound that he was doing the first fight. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, if it goes the distance, Sonnen, but I have Silva in two.
I have Silva in two also.
Yeah. I think. I'm gonna go with Sonnen.
Okay.
So you're saying it's gonna go distance?
No, well, shit, man. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, in all honesty, I can't. I mean, that's our thing with the show. We have to pick a winner. But it's hard because, you know what I mean, either one can take it. Like you said, it all depends on how Silva comes out. And let's not give all the credit to Silva either. It's all about how Sonnen comes out as well. I mean, he comes out banging, dude. I've never really seen Silva take a shot to the jaw. You know what I'm saying? But you never know. I mean, that's the whole thing with the MMA. I mean, everybody has a puncher's chance.
No, we saw Sonnen's best there. I think we can all agree to that. And it didn't beat Silva no matter what. You know, if Silva was hurt, he still didn't take advantage of it as much as he could have.
Sonnen was at a point where he got frustrated. I mean, he was trying to clap him with his hands. That's how frustrated he was, because he was like, okay, well, I'm doing all this damage to this man, but he's not showing any damage. He's still here. He's still defending himself. He's still getting pulling full guard and is still trying to win this fight. So he just gave up in the fifth round and he got caught.
I'm gonna have to change. I'm gonna have to go to Silva, because you're right. Sonnen didn't have him on his back the whole time, grounding and pounding, and he couldn't finish him. And even to top that off, everybody's saying that Silva wasn't at his best at the time. So even if not being at his best and he still couldn't finish him, then now that he's supposed to be on point, I'm just saying, I think if anybody's going to beat Silva, it'll be Sonnen.
No, that's true, too. I mean, also, we could probably already start talking about it. His streak eventually has to come to an end, Silva.
Yeah. So I mean, it would really suck to have to fucking retire if he retires with the belt. You know what I'm saying? Because that would be whack. I need to see somebody beat the shit out of him. You know, well, I'm just
let's look a little bit into the future in regards to, let's say Sonnen loses, but it's close. Is there going to be a part three? I mean, at this point, can anybody beat Silver? Who they would they ask Bones to go to there? I mean, what drop Man. Weight? I mean, how what would who's going to be the guy? Well, GSP?
I Silver?
Mean,
I don't think so. unless they pay Silver a whole lot of money, I doubt he's going to be. He's going to try to fight Jones. Straight up.
Yeah, I doubt it either.
He's not going to want to get fucking embarrassed.
Really, the only other guy would be GSP, and if he goes up to the weight, which is, they've already said they don't want to do that against each other because they're like real good friends or some shit, right?
Man, I wish they would. I wish they would just get it over with.
Well, I don't know. I think the last time I heard is that the super fight is actually closer to happening than it ever was. You know what I mean? It all depends on what happens with GSP's fight versus fucking, what's his name? His next fight versus Conduit or Kondu, it Kondu,
Kondu,
Kondu, Kondu. I always said Conduit for some reason.
Yeah, because he had that U in his name, but it's silent and shit.
Yeah, what the fuck? That bullshit.
Yeah, not right.
They retarded ass names. But yeah, you know what I'm saying. So I don't know. Either way, this is gonna be a good fight.
That's pretty much it, man. Let us know what you all think. I'm hella excited for it. If you're not in the UFC, if you're still into that whack ass boxing. Get into UFC, man. UFC is where it's at.
Yeah,
we out, dog. Peace.
Ouch!